Hey guys, Jay Styles here from Dallas, Texas, and I have the assistance of the beautiful Miss Haley Sicking, world famous singer and dancer. You need to check her out, world famous opera singer. We're about to start the cha-cha class, so hopefully you guys already have your cha-cha basics down, and we can have a little fun with this and turn around and play for the next 30 minutes. If you like the class, definitely check me out on latindanceonline.com. I got hundreds of videos for 20 bucks a month, and you can get on there and you can practice from the comfort of your own home or wherever you happen to be. So, starting this out, we are going to go here. We are starting with a regular basic cha-cha. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, you're 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8, and we're going to cross that 1 and transfer your weight to it. So you want to lock the leg out, that way it transfers your weight. You don't want to be on the back half, you want to be on the front half of the step. Let's try it again. 6, 7, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2. And we're just going to put the toe. You won't have to move from there, just 2 and giving the toe. Good. Then from here, we're going to cross over again. And then we're going to go toe. Then we're going to cross over again. And we're going to do toe. Good. So when we take this, we're going 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. You're 5, 6, 7. Good. Let's try it again. 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3. Over 5, 6, 7. Over 1, 2, 3. You're 5, 6, 7. Good. Now, a common misconception that a lot of people have is that cha-cha is always fast, and you always got to be doing something fast. But these nice little slow movements right here, or slow motions that we do right here, allow us to start to add in that sex appeal and actually start to dance. I tell my students all the time, when you're dancing, the dancing is not on the numbers. It's not on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The dance is actually in between the numbers, where you actually start to play. You don't go 1, 2, you would go, and 1, 2, 3, 5, you right? So you're actually dancing in between those. So when we take it through, let's just go from here, from that 1. We're going to cross 1. We're going to go 2. I want you to sit down into your right hip. So you're sitting into your hip. Now from here, I want you to push it over to your left leg and then drop it back down in place. So when we take this, we're going 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Let's try that again. 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. Then from here, we cross over 5, and then we put the foot out, shift your weight again. So now your weight's into your left hip. And then from here, we're going to shift it out, bring it back in, and cross. We shift again, we push it out, come back in, and cross, and over, shift it out, and back in. Good, good, good. So when we take it, we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we go back into our cha-cha basic. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. Good. Let's try that. 6 from the basic first. 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now from here, we're going to pick up high and cross back. We're going to pick up high and cross back. So what I want you to do is cross close to the foot, almost like you were trying to push your foot back forward as we go through. So when we take that, we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. Good. Let's try it again. 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, you're 6, 7. Now from here, we're going to cross back one more time. 8, back in place, and 1. Good. And so we're going to bring it back forward. So when we take it, we have our 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Good. And then from here, we're going to pose for 2. Just strike a pose. That's all I want you to do. So when we take it, it's going to look like this. Watch. One, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So from there, I don't care what you do. You can do your hair. You can turn around and go. You can body roll your way through. That's all up to you, what your flavor feel like. And I find this, a lot of dancers have a hard time with silence in the music or dead space. A lot of dancers have a hard time with just, what do I do in dead space? I don't care. Make a goofy face. One, two, three, four, and five. You're six, you're seven, you're eight, and one. Five, six, seven. I don't care. Let's try it again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five. You're six, seven, eight, and one. Pose two, three, bring them together. Four, five, you're six, seven, eight, and one. Good, let's try it from the top. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five. Six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, you're five. Six, seven, eight, you're one. Two, three, four, you're five, six, seven, basic, one, two, three, bring it back, you're five, you're six, seven, you're eight, and one, two, three, you're five, six, seven, eight, and one. Good. Now, from there, we're coming back through, we've gone six, seven, we're going to go eight and feet together, then from here, I want you to push over, one, we're going to push over to the side. So from here, let's try just that, we're going to go eight and one, then from here we're gonna go two and three, four and five, six and seven. Good, good, good. So once you go over, you're just marching with your legs crossed. Nothing too complicated about that. Let's try it again. We're going eight and one, two and three, four and five, six and seven. Good. Now, a tip that will go with this is the butt. If when you go through, actually try this, a couple of things. I want you to take your toes of this foot and I want you to push your weight onto this leg and then ease it back down. So don't collapse, but push up and then ease yourself, control yourself on the way back down. So when you go, I'm going like I'm trying to jump over a puddle. So I'm going eight and one, which is what allows the slide to happen as well. And what also adds to that is one, sit into that hip. So what you have is you have me standing on top of my leg. If I turn around and I push past my perimeter, it drags me. So it gives the illusion of the slide even more. So when you're taking, I have my eight and one, two and three, four and five, six and seven, eight and one. Make sense? So you're actually pushing yourself through and then allowing that hip to slide past your perimeter and you'll go right over. Six, so we're going eight and one, two and three, four and five, six and seven, eight and one. And we can go back to a basic. Make sense? So let's try that from the backity back. Let's try that. We're going one, two, three, four and five. Back six, you're seven, you're eight and one, two, three, E, you're five, six, seven, you're eight, and one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, you're six, you're seven. Yes? Let's try it from the top, see what we get. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five, go six, seven, you're eight, and cross, tap, hip, back. Let's try it again. From the top, from the top. Haley's learning this right with you guys. I haven't taught her any of this. Let's try it again. Six, seven. We have one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven. You're eight and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You're one, two, three, four. You're five, six. Backity back. You're one, two, three, four, and five. You're six, seven, eight, and one, two, three. You're five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven. Good. One more time. Six, seven. We have one, two, three, four, and five. Your hip thrusts, you're eight and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You're one, two, three, four, your five, six, seven, eight, backity back, two, three, four, and five, your six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, your five, six, seven, make your slide, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, your six, seven, good, ready to go on, yeah, all right, we're going here, we're going one, and on my two, I'm going to angle it this way, towards that corner right there. It's a 45, 46 degree angle, 46 and a half. So aim for 46 and a half. So we're going to go one, two, three, four, and five. And what we're doing is we're going to make just a little small semicircle. So we're going one, two, three, four, and five, back six, seven. Good. Let's try it again. We're going one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven. So all we're doing is putting that six to the back again. So all we've done is taken the basic step and turned it like that. Let's try it again. Six, seven. We have one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven. Good. And now from here, we're going to start making our way back here. We're going to go eight and one, and we're going to cross over. Good. Let's try it again. We're going one, two, three, four, and five. You are six, seven, eight, and one. Good. Let's try it again. Six, seven. We have one, two, three, four, and five. You are six, seven, eight, and one, two. Good. Now, between that six and that seven, I want you to act like you're getting ready to go in a race. On your mark, get set, go. And you would push from the ball of the foot. You wouldn't push flat-footed. Nobody does that. Now, from here, when you straighten your leg, it pushes your butt out. If you don't let your heel come down, you're pushing off. So on your mark, get set, go. It's a very natural movement. So from here, all I'm doing is taking that and adding a body roll to, or a butt roll to it. So I'm going boom and shifting myself over in between the steps. So we have our one, two, three, four, and five. My six, roll, seven, eight, and one, two. Good, let's try it again. And two will be right back to that corner again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five. You are six, seven, eight, and one. And your eight and one, I want you to make it really tight. Look at how much I moved during my eight and one. One, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and one. I'm tiptoeing on top of myself, not trying to go for distance. Let's try it again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and one. And then from here, we're gonna go two, and then when I transfer my weight to three, I'm gonna slide my foot, turning myself back to this side. So what's going to happen is that's going to now put us at a 46, no, that's about a 46 and a half right there. Yeah, I think so. So watch, it's going one, two, three, four, and five. And we're going to put it right back to the side. Let's try that again a few times. We're going one, two, three, four, and five. Good. So when we do the four and five, we go through, swing it all the way back, four, and then bring the foot back together. And now you don't have to go anywhere. It takes up less space. Again, six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five. Good, again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five. Good, now from here, tuck behind, six, push off, seven, and now from here, we're gonna do like we did before. We're gonna go eight and one and turn ourselves right back around where we were. Let's try that again. And he's like, what did I get myself into? I said, yes, Jay. Let's try it again. Six, seven, we have one, two, slide, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and one. Good, so on the eight and one, we just turn ourselves around. Let's try it again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, back eight, and one. So you're using the eight and one to create the turn. So once you have your one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, then you just use the eight and one to turn yourself back this way. Let's try it again. Six, seven, we have one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and one. And then from here, we're gonna step our two out. And what I want you to do is you can give yourself ball pressure. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a little Mufasa to this. I want you to take your booty and go north, go west, go south, and then bring yourself back into your cha-cha. So all you doing is putting a little roar on. You just, arr. So you got your little Mufasa thing going on. You're like, arr, boom, bitch, right? Yeah, I mean, sorry, I watch too much TikTok. I'm stuck at the house. I'm stuck in the house and I'm in a house bored. Okay, whatever. So let's try it again. We're going. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Growl. 3, 4, 5. You're 6, 7. So you can make that as sexy as you want to or what have you. You can add a body roll into it. I don't care. That's some more you time. So let's take that. I just try it from the top slow. I'll let you guys see it. I'll let you guys see it. Let's bring it. We'll work ourselves up. We have our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hip thrust. 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Backity back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3. Back 5, 6. Corner. And you're 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 5. Sorry, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Good. Let's bring it back. Let's bring it back up. We got it. We got this. We have our. Let's try it from the backity back. Let's build up from there. I think you guys are cool up to there. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Back 6. You're 7. You're 8, and 1, 2, 3. 4, you're 5, 6, slide 7, 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 5, 6, and 7, 8, and 1. Then from here, we're going to go into the semicircle. We have our 2, 3, back 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Good. Let's try it again from the backity back. We have our 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2. 3, bring it in, you're 5, 6, over, you're 8 and 1, 2 and 3, 4 and 5, 6 and 7, semicircle, 2, 3, 4 and 5, you're 6, 7, 8 and 1, and then from here we go into the slide, we have our 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, turn 8 and growl, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Good, good, good. Let's try it again from the top. 6, tippity top. 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're 1, 2, 3, 4. You're 5, 6, 7, 8. You're 1, 2, 3. Backity back. You're 5. You're 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2. E, you're 5, 6, slide 7, 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 5, 6, and 7, 8, and semicircle, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're 6, 7, 8, and 1. Second slide, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. Turn 8 and growl, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're 6, 7. Now on the growl, you can cheat. You can go 2, 3, 4, and 5, or you can go 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. So you can milk that all the way to 5 if you have something super sexy that you want to do. So let's try that with a little music. See what we get. Let's start with the basic. 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4.
Decía Ramón Puntilla, cuando a su mamá llamó, tengo un pollo sabrosito, con el que quiero casarme. Pero acaban de informarme que no, que no me puedo casar, porque es novia de mi amigo, y eso sí da que pensar. Odio a todos
6, los que 7, aman. 8, and 1. And you guys like that.
Que wow. Felices están.
8, and 1, 2, 3,
porque
4,
yo
5,
6, que me comprenda 7, 8, 1, 2, y que me diga papi
4, 5,
y que 6, me quiera
7,
bien
back, 1, 2,
Dios mío ayúdame
7,
8, 1, 2, 3, quiero olvidar ayúdame ayúdame
now back to our
ayúdame a olvidarla te lo pido ayúdame, ay que yo la quiero tanto, y no la quiero perder.
Like that. We're going to try a couple of more songs that way you guys can kind of get the feel for it. And like I said, it's just repetition. Right now, it's just jam session. You guys knocked it out very fast. Not too many of y'all had questions. That was awesome. Thank you guys. Y'all were such an attentive audience. And if you like this stuff, definitely check me out on latindanceonline.com. Let's go ahead and play with another song, see if we can get it.
I like that one, though.
Wait till the next one.
Fried neck bone and some home fries.
Okay, now we're going to knock out just another little piece because I want to play with this. I haven't danced in a while, so I need to see if my legs actually still work for me.
Like
so
8 months.
We're going to, right? Hopefully you guys like this. And like I said, check us out on latindanceonline.com. And I hope you guys are enjoying the festival. And like I said, tune in. I'm going to be emceeing. It's going to be a great time. Thank you so much, Bachata George. Thank you, Miss Haley. And we're going to play with a little bit of this song, see what happens. And no promises. And I just feel like getting a little energy out. So hope you guys enjoy. Enjoyed. This was, I know, 30 minutes flies by fast. 30 minutes flies by fast. Like I said, I just wanted to challenge you guys a little bit and have a little fun and play. But I hope you guys are being safe out there. I hope you guys are definitely social distancing. Make sure you got your handy sandy with you. Make sure you're using your handy sandy when you're out dancing in class. Mask up and cover up and be safe. Hopefully the scene will come back soon enough and I'll get to see you guys again in person. Thank you to the beautiful Miss Haley Sicking. And I love you guys. Like I said, you can rewind this as much as you would like, or you can check me out on latindanceonline.com. And remember, if it ain't sexy, don't do it.
Super happy to be here in this special edition of Dallas Bachata Festival. I am Pablo Vliches and I have this beautiful dance partner just for this time from Spain, is
Melanie Linde.
And we together will teach you Bachatango. This is an old fusion but at the same time a new fusion because it's always in a constant process of evolution. Is the mix in between bachata and tango. Sensuality and passion. Sensuality and passion. So, let's start with the first basic step that we created 20 years ago in 1999. So the lowest part of the body is bachata movement and the upper part of the body is tango well hat. We will do basic. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And 1, 2, 3, and tap, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And 1, 2, 3, and tap, 5, 6, 7, and stop. With this basic, we will do the basic 2, which is in a linear way in 1, 2, 3, and tap, 5, 6, 7, and tap. 1, 2, 3, tap, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 4. Like you can see, the ladies' movement is always with a hips movement, very, very sensual. And we are in charge of lead every single movement. The upper part of the body needs pressure from the guy with the left hand going down and with the lady going up. Okay? You got it? So let's dance a little bit with these two first basic, which is 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 6, 7, and 8. Since this moment, we will start to use some tango, little movements, and put inside of the bachata basic steps and patterns. For example, ochos, ganchos, and boleas. ¿Cómo son los ochos?
Ok, los ochos de la chica. Voy a abrir mi pierna derecha y voy a empezar a hacer el ocho. Estiro la pierna izquierda, cambio peso y por el suelo, que tengo que escuchar el ruido, junto a mis pies, ¿vale? Tobillos bien juntitos. Y hacia el otro lado, ya estoy. Y ya estoy. Y ya estoy. La cadera va en relación con los hombros, ¿sí? Va seco. Y me giro y ya estoy.
So, like you can see, Melanie is, first of all, she's starting to make the step with the other leg, okay, straight the leg. After that, she changed the weight, and she straight the right leg. And after that, she joined, twist her hips, and again, the process start going with the straight the leg and go. And change the word. That is named ochos. So you have ochos. Front ochos and back ochos. Ochos para atrás. Bien. Y vamos a usar este movimiento dentro de la bachata para crear nuestro paso del bachatango. We will use this movement for creating our first bachatango movement, connecting the basic one. And ocho, you will see, 1, 2, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4. From this moment, we turn the lady with the left hand, one half, and she's now, you have a beautiful cambre, and we go. So the counting will be, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. ¿Lo tenemos? Vamos a hablarlo desde el otro perspectiva y en español. Hacemos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 y 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8, 1, 2, 3, cambre, 5, 6, 7 y 8. ¿Ok? No es cualquier cambre. ¿Cómo lo hacemos?
Vale, chicas, termino mi giro, dejo el peso en la pierna derecha para sacar mi pierna izquierda bien estiradita desde la ingle hasta el dedo gordo del pie y va relajando la espalda y relajando el bracito.
When you bring the lady to you with the left hand in her back, she's going down, and when you bring the lady to you, you bring up the lady first, and with the right hand, turn a little bit. For restart with the one with your left leg and the right leg of the lady. Okay? Empezamos ya. Otra vez al siguiente movimiento, porque en esta clase queremos enseñarte varios movimientos, desde lo más básico algo un poquito más avanzado. ¿Bien? Entonces, vamos a continuar con el detalle. Me gustaría, Melanie, si puedes mostrarle en este giro la mujer cómo hace esa elegancia de giro los brazos para poner al hombre mientras yo pongo la música.
Vale, ok, chicas. Piso, ¿vale? Voy a girar con los pies juntitos, tobillos bien juntitos. Me estiro hacia arriba y coloco este bracito en ángulo de 90, ok, y giro a mi pareja hasta hacer el giro entero hacia allí, ok. Entonces, voy a pisar, ángulo recto, la mano la pongo en el hombro contrario para no molestar, hasta que la relajo para hacer el cambre, ¿Sí? Lo más importante es tener los pies juntitos, que es lo que hace que se me vea bonita. La espalda hacia arriba para poder girar. Y aquí, relajo toda la espalda, recuerda, relajo mi brazo y subo. Con la ayuda del chico es más fácil hacer el cambio. ¿Ok? Vamos.
Lo hacemos una vez más. Antes. 1, 2, 3 y 4, 5, 6, 7 y. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From other point of view, we'll do 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. Let's start. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the movement number 2, Eiffel movement. Let's continue for the last movement. For that you need ganchos. Abrimos. Y aquí la mujer hace un gancho por fuera. ¿Cómo se hace eso?
Vale, tengo todo mi peso en la pierna derecha. La izquierda la tengo estirada y voy a cruzar mi rodilla con rodilla mientras estiro mi pierna. Y ya está.
Además, ella siente que el hombre la eleva, junto atrás, eleva su cuerpo de abajo. Arriba, abajo, arriba. Y si tú quieres ayudarla más, tócala con tu pierna derecha. I mean, it's not exactly the way of lead in tango. It's very similar, but we have some license for help, for an extra help to your dance partner using your legs. In tango, you never use the legs for lead. But in Bachatango it's possible. So you do one, two, three, and four. From here we go to the other side. So five, six, look at it. The guy go for outside. Seven and again, eight. From here we do two eights. One, two, three, four, and now four small ochos. Five, six, seven, eight. Turn the leg. One, two, three, four. We do a molino. ¿Cómo es un molino? Melanie.
Primero sube mi brazo derecho, luego sube mi izquierdo como si fuesen aspas de molino.
Como Don Quijote, porque te estamos enseñando desde España. Como Don Quijote de la Mancha. You know? So from here, we do boom, and you take the left hand of the lady, hace que se acaricie suavemente. Importante, caballeros, no pases tu mano por el cuerpo de ella porque eso no es elegante. Tango es pasión, bachata sensualidad. Pasión es elegancia. So,
por entero, que me ayude a olvidarla.
Hi everyone, I'm Jose Hernandez. Most of you know me by Fluffy in the dance community. I'm here to personally invite you to the 2020 International Dallas Bachata Festival, taking place October 22nd through 25th. Now we all know that Bachata George always throws an amazing event, and this year will be no different. However, with COVID-19 causing havoc around the world, this year's festival will be taking place entirely online using the YouTube platform and will be 100% free. Now we need you to go to youtube.com/Dallas Bachata Festival and click the red subscribe button. Then look at the video section and set reminders on content premiering soon that is of interest to you. And don't forget, hit the bell notification near the subscribe button so you are notified of future published content on the Dallas Bachata Festival YouTube channel. For more event information, including the full schedule, visit www.dallasbachatafestival.com. With much love, stay safe, Fluffy out.